It's the first weekend Joel has off since I arrived in Fiji, and we decided it was absolutely necessary to spend a weekend away exploring the Yasawa Islands. As we only had 2 days, we needed somewhere relatively close to Nandi, so we would have less time travelling and more time getting acquainted with our temporary island home.
We've made it.
Water is amazing.
Photos just do it justice.
Barefoot Kuata Island Resort is at the gateway of the Yasawa Islands, with white sand beaches, volcanic mountains and rock caves. It's a 2 hour ferry ride, or more like 2.5 hours on Fiji time from Nandi. It was a smooth sail and we were greeted with a traditional warm Fijian welcome.
Hula!
Barefoot Kuata Resort has a strong focus on conservation. The area you see mapped in red covers approximately 1.3 k's of the island and is all marine protected. This area restricts fishing, oil and gas exploration and mining in order to protect and conserve natural and cultural resources. Barefoot Kuata is an eco-inspired resort and is the only resort on the island. X marks the spot. That's us.
So, we have just arrived at Barefoot Kuata Lodge and it is so stunning here. I'll take you on a little tour of our safari hut.
Bed.
This is our little outdoor shower. Amazing. Bathroom. Toilet. Sink, all outside, so you can enjoy the sunshine. And look at our view. Look at that. Stunning. Absolutely stunning. Fair to say, I think we are going to enjoy our stay here.
We were told the island is home to a large amount of black tip reef sharks, so naturally we jumped straight in the water to say hi to our fishing friends. She can be calm, she can be wild.
Thank you.
it in your eyes when you kissed me, tangerine. And if all this is a dream, I wouldn't mind us drifting to sleep, where the days, they move easy, and the waves, they don't mean as much to me as I used to believe. The days, they move easy, it occurs, when you are here, the waves, they wash away from me.
Sharks, black tip reef sharks. We've just had a snooze and now we're toddling down to the bar to have a beer.
John just stubbed
his toe. Now we're heading to the bar to have a well-deserved beer, beverage, if you will.
Several
beverages. How do you rate your day today, Jolly?
11 out of 10.
We're going to have a nice early night tonight because tomorrow we're getting up to go for a shark dive, which will be scary, but
real shark.
Very cool, so we're very excited.
They move easy, and the curves, when you are here, the waves, they wash away from me.
Beautiful view this morning. Joel and I are prepping for our shark dive this morning, which we're a little bit nervous but very excited about. The Yasawa shark dive, the awakening, is renowned for bull sharks and tiger sharks, lemon sharks, hammerhead sharks, so it'll be interesting to see what they're like in their natural habitat, because they get a bit of a bad rap.
22 meters.
In Australia. 22 meters deep. And so I think we just hang out behind cages. And
not behind cages, no, it's just like a shelf. You're open water.
Oh, it's open water. Mm. It's even scarier. and then the dive master feeds them. Mm. So we saw some videos last night of people that did it yesterday, and it looks like a pretty close encounter.
And they look big.
They do look big. So, yeah, we're excited. Breathing. Put a wetsuit on, come on. Starting to get nervous.
Blame it on the friend.
survived the shark dive. We survived the shark dive. We survived the shark dive. So Jolie, tell me about your shark dive.
It was unbelievable. You get down there and all of a sudden there's just, you see little ones and then you get deeper and deeper, got down to about 22 meters and then before you know it, there's just these 9-10 foot bull sharks.
Are they that big?
Yeah, they are. Yeah, they're huge. And they're coming so close, you're hiding behind about a 2 foot wall and you feel like you're squashed down behind it. And these things get fed right in front of you. They come straight up over the top of you. It's just unbelievable.
It was pretty incredible. But they seem so docile, don't they?
They do, yeah. I think they're pretty used to being around the feeders and
the divers all have names for them, so yeah. I dare say that they are regulars at that particular spot.
But it's just an incredible experience. There's nothing like it I've ever done before.
Really cool. Not scary at all.
No, surprisingly not scary. You'd kind of expect to be really freaked out when you first see them, but once you're down there with them, and you see how calm and, well, how calm they can be. It's kind of settling a little bit.
Yeah. Only bull sharks. No tigers or lemons or hammerheads, unfortunately. But
we can't complain.
During the Fiji summer, it's mating season, so that may have something to do with it. But it was amazing nonetheless. And
now
we are celebrating with a glass of champagne from our lovely friend Drew, who was one of the original people to set up this awakening dive on Barefoot Kuata Island.
So Fiji Tree
thank
Solutions.
You, Drew.
Fiji
you
Tree Solutions.
Legend.
He's getting on the river.
Sadly, our time on Kuata Island was coming to an end. It was amazing. Snorkeling, diving, relaxing, good food and good company. Everything we wanted for our weekend away. If you're thinking about a getaway in Fiji, make sure you look into the Yasawa Islands. Kuata Island is just one of six absolutely stunning, remote and unspoiled islands of Fiji. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.